Good morning, children, and welcome back to our online classes once more. Today we are going to start with a new story, My Childhood by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. This is an excerpt. Excerpt means a part of his autobiography, Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire is more than autobiography. It is India's Wings of Fire. It is India's greatest dream that was made possible by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. To succeed in life and achieve results, one must understand and master three mighty forces. One is belief, desire, and expectation. Every single word of Wings of Fire is overfilled, flowing with desire, belief, and expectations of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Abdul Pakir Jainaluddin Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 at Rameswaram in Tamil Nadu. He was born in a middle class South Indian family. His father, Jainaluddin, was not a very rich person, but he had innate wisdom. Innate means inherent, inbuilt wisdom. And he also didn't have any formal education, but he had his helpmate in his wife, Ashiyamma. Abdul Kalam was a short boy with very, very normal looks. He lived in a fairly large pucker house on Mosque Street without any kind of luxuries. But he enjoyed a very secure childhood, both emotionally and materially. 1939, Second World War started. He was born in 1931. I'm talking about 1939, Second World War started. The child was 8 years old. Tamarind seeds, imli seeds, you know, they were in much demand that time. That 8 years old child started selling tamarind seeds. And at the end of the day, he used to get one anna. So he was very happy with that kind of collection. But soon India had to join the Allied forces. What is the meaning of Allied forces? Allied forces means when friendly countries or when countries become friends with each other to fight for one mission against one enemy, against one cause. It is known as Allied forces or friendly forces. So India joined the Allied forces and soon emergency was declared. When emergency was declared, Rameswaram had stopped becoming the station halt, the train halt anymore. So newspapers used to be bundled and they used to be thrown out of the moving train. They used to be thrown out of the moving train because the train stopped halting at Rameswaram anymore because of the emergency. Abdul Kalam, along with his cousin Samsuddin, used to collect those newspapers and used to distribute them. He earned money for the first time in his life and he was grateful to Samsuddin for teaching him the value of earning. Abdul Kalam inherited self-discipline and honesty from his father and goodness and kindness from his mother. He had three close friends, Ramananda Shastri, Aravindam and Shiva Prakasan. These three friends belonged to Hindu Orthodox families, but never the four of them understood that they were different from each other. Their friendship was so pure, so honest, and so unique. Later on, Ramananda joined his father's profession. His father was a priest in the village temple. So Ramananda Shastri became the priest. Aravindan took up transport business, and Siva Pratasan became the railway catering contractor. And Abdul Kalam, what did he become? Okay, so we move on to one day of his school life. One day, as he was sitting behind Ramananda Shastri, he was separated from his friend by his new teacher. The new teacher asked him to go and sit at the back because he was a Muslim wearing a cap, and Ramananda Shastri was wearing the sacred thread across his chest. So the two boys were separated, and as he was going to the back of the class, he was pained, he was shocked to see that Ramananda was crying. Later on, when the class was over, these three friends, along with Abdul Kalam, they went and complained to their parents. Lakshmana Shastri, Ramananda's father, came and scolded the teacher very harshly, saying that he was not supposed to spread any kind of communal differences among the children, among the innocent hearts of the children. The teacher was overcome with guilt and apologized. His science teacher, Siva Krishna Iyer, had lots of fascination for Abdul Kalam. One day he was invited over to his house for dinner, but his wife was uncomfortable, and Siva Krishna Iyer neither scolded his wife nor said anything loudly or harshly. He sat beside the boy and served him with his own hands. So this is the way Abdul Kalam spent his childhood, under the blessings and the good wishes of his teachers, friends and family. Later on, the World War had ended. It was very clear that India would be winning. And this happiness, this spirit of happiness, spread all over the country that India is going to win. And when this was so optimistic everywhere, when optimism or happiness had spread, Abdul Kalam wanted to leave Rameswara and move on to Ramanathapuram for his studies. What did his father say that time? He asked for permission. And what did his father say? His father said that you are like the seagull, and the seagull flies close to the sun, all alone without a nest. So fly out like the seagull. His mother had objected, and his father immediately said that your children, they are not only your children, but the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. They have their own thoughts. With all the blessings of his father, APJ Abdul Kalam left Rameswara for higher studies and spread out his wings of fire. God bless you, children. I hope you have followed this story, and if you haven't, please connect as soon as possible. Read the lesson. Stay happy. Stay blessed. Thank you.